Are you ready to take a peek at a true Colorado golden nugget? Nestled in the majestic Colorado Rocky Mountains, the crisp air at over 10,000 feet pierces my lungs in the nation's highest incorporated city, Leadville, Colorado. Tucked away in the historical district lies a 1899 vintage Victorian building, the National Mining Hall of Fame and Museum. Stretching over three stories into the thin air of the near 2 mile high city, offering a breathtaking overview of Leadville and into the Rocky Mountains beyond from the observation terrace. With five levels of themed rooms exploding with mining history from when it all started to what the future of mining could bring. Some calling it the Smithsonian of the Rockies. Let me ask you a question. What does mining mean to you? Maybe more than you even realize? Please take a trip with me and grab your shovel, and together we can dig into America's boom and bust story of mining. Upon entering, I was instantly distracted by all the welcoming artifacts and bright lights just inside the doors. The staff at the front desk was very professional, friendly, and extremely informative. After paying the small admission fee, we were provided with the treasure map to the building and the recommended path to provide the best experience. I was already impressed, and I wasn't even out of the lobby. My museum adventure started with an unreal collection of specimens. The room was filled with sparkling gems, radical rocks, and colorful crystals. Some of the specimens took over thousands of years to form. It was truly stunning to be surrounded by such an intense collection of minerals of different types, sizes, from around the world. I also found the Colorado specific mineral collection to be very intriguing, as I was introduced to a few that I was unaware of and have the possibility to stumble upon on one of my own adventures through Colorado. I cannot put into words the amount of specimens they had on display. I had no idea the variety of mineral styles, types, sizes, and colors that were on the earth. Thank you. No matter your age, you are sure to be fascinated by the entertaining and educational life-size mine replicas. Taking all of your senses on a trip back in time, from the smell of the authentic wood beams and mining equipment from old active mines, to the automated sounds and visual interactions the mine provides along the trip. Surrounded by historical artifacts and lifelike displays of mining production, it was a true mine experience. The coal mine was very interesting. Knowing they came from ancient swamps and numerous remnants of artifacts have been discovered in coal mines, the underground coal mine experience highlighted some of the unique solutions to one of the extremely hazardous conditions of coal mining. Oxygen levels would fluctuate and change throughout our coal mines. The miners would use a canary bird in the mine. Canary birds are known for singing, but it was determined that the canary would stop singing when oxygen levels would drop below 20%. Although this level was safe for the miners, it was the warning they needed to know when it was time to get out. The canary bird provided a valuable asset that was crucial to coal mining and was truly a lifesaver for the miners. Perched at the top of the stairs overviewing the lobby was a life-size single-jack miner statue, in honor to the miners that hand-jacked holes into rocks to blast deeper into our mines. It would take about 1 hour to drill 1 foot, and needing up to 10 holes to provide the adequate coverage of explosives to extend into the mine properly. Knowing that 250,000 miles of underground mines running under Leadville, and knowing that the process the miners had to use just to progress 1 foot at a time, I can't even put that into a perspective. Constructing over 260,000 miles or 1,372,800,000 feet of mines, and to think the majority of that was created 1 foot at a time. Wow. That is truly a testament to the miners that came before us. It also explains how Leadville was one of the most productive mining districts in the world. Boom days are still celebrated today, having friendly contests and challenges to honor and impersonate what the miners had to endure to drill the holes to continue mining.
I don't know about you guys, but I can barely hit a nail with a hammer, so it is extremely impressive that they can take one-arm swings with this giant sledgehammer and be as accurate and consistent as they are onto these drills. I would feel really bad for the guy holding my drill bit. There is not any way I would be holding a drill bit for somebody. I'm sorry, but I don't trust myself swinging a hammer, much less someone else. advancements in drilling technology was life-changing for the miners. Don't get me wrong, I'm sure Steve here is making this look way easier than it is, but anything has to be better than one hammer swing at a time.
The Prospector's Cave is truly unbelievable. I can't even put into words or into this video of what it felt like experiencing the Prospector's Cave. The trickling water and the ambient lighting sets the scene to the quartz wall from the Iditarod mine near Telluride. And an iron pyrite wall from the Eagle Mine, one of Colorado's oldest mines. A rare opportunity to see the natural form of a mineral-rich wall in a mine. The mesmerizing shimmer and glisten off the surrounding walls was a view you had to see to truly believe. The collection of historical mining artifacts was astonishing. Starting from the ancient mining tools dating back to 1800 BC to the modern day tools and computer technology we use in mining today. From small hand tools and scales to model replicas of larger equipment, some even offering the hands-on experience. Like the displayed Rockerbox sluice, once very popular amongst prospectors. There was so much to see, a remarkable collection of novelty items, crucial artifacts to our mining history. multiple displays, model replicas of the mines, and prospectors' journeys throughout mining. It was a great depiction of the way of life and shows what truly had to be endured and the incredible obstacles that had to be overcome to succeed in mining. The timelines on display embrace the time that has passed as the mining industrial history unfolded, documenting the booms and of course the bust of the history of mining through the timeline gives a great perspective on how fast the evolution of mining truly happened. A special thanks to all the great men and women who have fought for the America we have today. We all have connections to the military. I would like to send a personal thank you to my grandpa, Ernie Contreras, who has endured the Korean War to keep us Americans safe.
The advancements over time have revolutionized the mining industry. Thank you to all the miners that have evolved mining into what it is today. Some of my personal favorites were the Leadville Ice Palace. The amount of detail, effort, time, and energy it took to build both the model replica and the life-size palace is truly astonishing. The patient structure on display, created by a local Leadville man, was a three-dimensional diary of his life. The story and structure together left me speechless. The Gold Room. Do I really need to explain myself here? This place definitely rounds out my top three personal favorites. I found it crazy the amount of money and supplies it required to start a mining journey. I feel you would have to be truly dedicated to your craft and passion if you were going to invest that type of money. Man, wouldn't it be great to trip over this thing while you're trying to prospect? The Gold Fact Wall provided some insightful information that opened my eyes to the facts of gold that I was not aware of. The industrial mining exhibit was an eye-opening experience, to say the least. The surprising information and hands-on experiences that educate you on everyday items that contain and require minerals that we mine to produce. Shining a light on the fact that everything we use in the world is either grown or mined. This information can easily be taken for granted and really shows the importance of mining to every single person. Some minerals can take over thousands of years to form, but some can form quickly, like halite, or better known as our table salt, something we consume every day. So, from the gold in your smartphone that you're probably watching this video on,
or the silver in the light switch you used this morning to turn on the light in the room, or even the salt on your French fries that you're possibly gonna have for lunch. Mining minerals is a vital part of life and society, providing us with must-have items, and of course luxury items and technology we have gained accustomed to. New technology is being made every day. The unique properties of silver alone can provide materials for solar panels, and also its antibacterial properties can be used to filter water. We are mining our way to a new future of technology. Last, but certainly not least, the National Mining Hall of Fame fills the top floor with images and bios of the icons of the mining industry that have been inducted. It was insane to see the amount of men and women that have impacted mining through history. From the prospectors, teachers, inventors, labor leaders, and beyond, filling the walls of the Hall of Fame. All coming from different walks of life with a different story, but all had one thing in common. All were everyday people that were hardworking, passionate, dedicated in the building and evolution of the mining industry, paving the way for us today. The National Mining Hall of Fame and Museum is a nonprofit organization that was founded and is maintained by generous supporters from the mining leaders to the mining companies all the way to the mining communities. In hopes to provide demonstration of the value of mining while commemorating to the brave men and women that created and built the American mining industry while preserving the history for thousands to see each and every year. A healthy mining industry in America provides us with life-depending resources, jobs, technology growth, income, and valuable assets to our country. Physical hard work is how the mining industry was built, and now due to the advancements of technology, the future of mining will forever be changed as the mining industry has become a leader in innovation. Mining to a better tomorrow. Now let me ask you that question again. What does mining mean to you? I am personally very proud that I was able to experience the National Mining Hall of Fame and Museum and share it with you. Taking just a small peek into the lives of the historical miners that shaped mining into what it is today. I highly recommend you personally take a trip into the Colorado Rocky Mountains. While taking a deep breath of the cool, crisp air, absorb in the history that surrounds you. With continuous additions and expansions, there is always something new and amazing to see at the National Mining Hall of Fame and Museum.